Something similar to what we studied last Sunday about the Word of God. Today is the will of God. Amen. What are you talking about? The will of God. The Word of God, the will of God, the mind of God, they are more or less the same thing. We're talking about the supremacy of God Almighty over our lives. We are going to read Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 2. Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 2. Are we there? Okay, let's read. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. If I may ask before we go, did we like the notes we gave? Do you want us to give you the notes? Okay, no response. All right. Praise the Lord. Amen. Which means you did not like the notes. Okay, we'll go on with the song. Hallelujah. Now, introduction. Being born again is the beginning of our spiritual journey. And the most important duty of a Christian is determination to do the will of God. The duty of a believer is that determination is your duty. That you determined to what? To do the will of God. So I pray that someone will have that determination in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So it's your duty, it is my duty to be determined to do the will of God. As we progress in the Christian journey, we are confronted with two choices, either to conform to the world or to be transformed by what? By the renewing of our mind. That will suggest to you that the progress a woman makes in the Christian journey is not automatic. You have to transit from one level to what? To another level of glory, of perfection, of praise, of giving, of service, of soul winning, of prayer. Your level must progress. Your neighbor, I pray that your level will progress. Move to the next level in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The faith with that choice, do I live where I am now, or do I move to the next level? Do I make progress? So that is the choice we are faced with in our journey as believers. Where would I say we should prove that we should prepare our minds and ourselves to do the will of God? And what is the will of God? What is the will of God? There's a question. The will of God is for us to please Him in all things, at all times. It is an issue of the mind before action. So our minds have to be subject to Christ's authority through transformation. For us to do this will of God is what? Is to please God in all things. And it's a thing of the will, it's a thing of the mind before it becomes a thing of action. Because God looks at the mind and He judges the intent and motives before He looks at what? At our actions. So doing the will of God, start from where? Start from the mind. And to do the will is to be obedient to Him in all things and at all times. I pray that someone here will make up his mind that I will be obedient to God in all things and at all times. Brethren, that is our calling. Amen? That is why we are Christians. That God may be glorified in our lives. The will of God. Now, talking about the mind, there are different kinds of minds. As we are seated here, there are different kinds of minds, and it depends on which mind you have, but you can change level. Amen?
Yes.
You can do what? You can change level. There's an unregenerated mind. That's the person who rejects Jesus. What do you call that mind? Unregenerated what? Mind. Praise the Lord. I pray that that mind is not here today. I believe that all of us are regenerated. Amen? If you are born again, say a big amen.
Amen.
That is true. If you are born again, say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Number two, there is this fallow mind. F-A-L-L-O-W. Follow up. Fallow mind. This mind has little or no appetite for the world or the things of God. No, the desire is deadened. The response lukewarm. There is display of apathy and weakness. If you notice that in your life, no, it's a thing of the mind. Amen.
Yes.
It's not that you don't have the you have. There's a power deposited in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But between the power and the action, the will is weak. The mind is weak. The transition is, as it were, it's rusty, clouded. And today I believe the Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
To clear off whatever is rough, whatever is the doubt, whatever is the fear, whatever the nuisance around the state of our mind, the cloud we clear in Jesus' name. Say a big amen to that.
Amen.
Say a big amen to that.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody. Unregenerated mind, a fallow mind, then you have a filthy mind. A filthy mind. This mind is, according to the scripture, is corrupt through deceitful desires. And it's not subject to the law of God. The person is in the church, but is corrupt through deceitfulness of the mind. And it's not subject to the law of God. It is like someone who feeds his mind with pornography, for example, is going to fall into this category. Amen? Somebody who chatters in the internet, or who chat in the internet, or how to do 419. Praise the Lord. Or how to do magic. It brings corruption, it corrupts the heart, and the heart weighs down, becomes weak, becomes carnal, and becomes natural. And the natural man cannot do what? Cannot please God. So that kind of mind cannot what? Cannot, because it's fed with junks, and in the things of God, junks are not allowed. Amen? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the King of glory.
Hallelujah.
That's the third mind. Then the fourth one, which is the last one, is a wholesome mind. A wholesome what? Wholesome one, robust, saturated. Amen. Strong and powerful. A wholesome mind. This mind is saturated by the word of God. It's filled with God's love. It's thirsty after righteousness. It minds heavenly things. It longs to be fruitful, to please, and to serve God. I pray that is your kind of mind in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But peradventure it is not there. We shall arrive there in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So we shall get there in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A robust, loving, thirsty, desiring, caring for the things of God, loving the brethren and all of that. So when I see bitterness and I see hatred, I just focus on the mind. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because an average believer has capacity to love. Hallelujah. Because Christ in us, the hope of what? The hope. Wholesome mind. That is what is called the mind of Christ in Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. He said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ. Verse 8 says, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. The mind of Jesus. Jesus became a man, but did not stop there. He moved on to perfect how to please God. He humbled himself and he learned obedience. I pray that all of us will learn obedience in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Obedience to a natural man is not natural. If you have spent so many years doing the things of the world, when you come to Jesus, you must learn the ropes. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You must learn how to do warfare. You must learn how to run from fornication. You must learn how to run from adultery. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You must learn the ropes. And anyone that refuses to learn the ropes will be reclusive. And I pray that we will not be good for nothing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But we shall be materials for honor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I would say, if a man or a woman releases himself from these things, repent from these things, he shall be what? A vessel unto honor. God is looking for vessels to use. I pray that you and I will be available in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say a big amen to that.
Amen.
Say you and I what? Will be available for the master's use at this end time.
Amen.
We're talking about the mind. We have to talk about the will of God. We have spoken about the will of God. And that the mind of a believer should be the robust mind, the wholesome mind. Not the oriented mind or fallow mind or filthy mind. So if your mind is filthy, do something about it. Praise the Lord. Maybe because of the environment. You have surrounded with yourself with filthy things. Your channels might be filthy. What you listen to on the radio, the books will be filthy. So check your environment and deal with it. Now if it's demonic, pray about it and destroy the power of the devil. There is power in you to deal with the devil. Amen?
Amen.
There's what? Power in you. In fact, you don't have to come to the pastor, pray for me. Of course, we are available for you in the name of Jesus. But by the powerful name of Jesus, every yoke is bound to be broken at the name of Jesus. Because that name I have been highly exalted above what? Above all other names. If Christ, who is interceding for you and I, cannot deliver you, then what is his business? That is his business right now of deliverance, of intercession. And it's much more closer to you than you think. Amen? Hallelujah. I pray that our minds will not be filthy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That is, we're talking about the mind. We have already said we must be transformed by the renewing of our minds. We say that we admonish not to be conformed to this world, but not to hold on to ideas and practices of our ungodly former lives. Not to be conformed to this world is not to hold on to practices of what? Of our former life. The means for us to be free from our former life is true transformation. Praise the Lord. That's what we're saying. And I pray that none of us will be bound to our past life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because if any man, any woman is in Christ, he's a new creature. All things what? Are passed away, behold, all things have become new. That reserves your place in eternity. Hallelujah. That places you on a pedestal of those who God answered prayers. God does miracles for those who have placed themselves, who have released themselves from the entanglement of the past, and are now claimed in the arena of God by grace and by the Holy Ghost power and the power of prayer. They get transformed and they move from glory to glory. I pray that will be a portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your life will not nosedive or diagnose in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But forward and upward ever.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are admonished not to be conformed, but what? To be transformed. We are rather to be transformed. And to be transformed is to allow the teachings of the Word of God to erase our old ways of living for the lifestyle of Jesus. Rather than being conformed to the things of the world, we are rather encouraged to what? To be transformed by the renewal of our mind. That we should allow our mind to be erased of our old ways of living for the new style in Christ. Amen? New ideas, new perspective, new relationship, new reaction. How we spend our money, our time, our playbook should be what Christ has given us. Amen? And as we begin to do that, he will nod his head and say, yes, I have children here. True children in what? In New Covenant Parish. The 300 Northwest what? 36th Street. I hope you know the number of this place. The address of this place. Praise the Lord. How many of us know our phone number here? The phone number of this church. The notice board has a phone number. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. May God take glory from this church.
Amen.
May God be honored from this church.
Amen.
May God be glorified from this church.
Amen.
That means your life and my life should be erased of old things, old pattern of life. Things that are not of God must go. That was a let fornication, adultery, never to be mentioned among what? Amongst us. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 22 to 24. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 22 to 24. He says, that ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lusts, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that you put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Put on the new man. Be renewed in the spirit of what? Of your mind. And put on who? The new man, Jesus Christ, who is created after God in righteousness and true holiness. I pray that will be your portion.
Amen.
That you have thrown away the old man and you are putting on the new man, Jesus, our Redeemer, Jesus, our Comforter, Jesus, the righteous one. I pray that that will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
To renew our mind is to reflect on the Word of God daily. With due diligence. We mentioned this last week. To renew your mind is to reflect on the scriptures daily with what? With due diligence, as in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. Joshua chapter 1 verse 8 says, let this book of the law not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate therein day and what? Day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. How many of us want to have good success here? The Bible says you should do what? Renew your mind daily through searching the scriptures. Hallelujah. I, as the pastor, should renew my mind, and you should also what? Renew your mind. Men, women, everybody, old and young, we should constantly engage in the renewal of our minds. Through looking at the scriptures, the Bible calls it the mirror. And as we do that, the Bible says we are moving from what? From glory to, you may not see it, but you are moving from one level of glory to another level of glory. And I tell you, the Bible says deep speaks to who? To deep. Now, glory is a, there's different kind of glory. By the time you soak yourself in the Word of God and you receive the glory of God and your mind is imbued and empowered, when the devil sees you, they will bow. Amen? Praise the Lord. Because of some of us, we are lightweight. We lack substance. When we speak, Satan will say, who is speaking there? And who born you? You say, I'm a child of God. I say, no, you're not a child of God. I can't see the evidence. I put that evidence in your mind of a child of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the King of glory.
Hallelujah.
There will be evidence. Like we say, it's deliberate. You have to do it cautiously, diligently, as in Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. The state of our mind is key to pleasing or displeasing God. That is why it has to be in readiness position. The state of your mind is the key. You remember call it kokoro? What do you call it in Igbo? Yes, Anita? Praise the Lord. Amen. Huh? The key. Kokoro. Amen. You want to please God. Is in your way. Amen. You want to bless somebody. At times it's not in your account, it's in your mind. Once your mind is resolved, the money will come out. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In fact, the fact that you late, you come late to church is where? It's not that we don't value what we have, we don't value God as we're supposed to value him, or respect him, or fear him. So you can, one can walk in any time he likes. When a little come and begin to look at time, something is not right. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Go help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So at times when there'll be problems, something of the way, maybe cut a flat tire, whatever it is. But a perpetual late comer to church must start where is Jesus? The honor, the respect for Christ in his heart. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
There must be appetite for God, fear of God in our hearts. Amen? And I pray God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It's the key, the state of the mind, to pleasing or displeasing God. That is why it has to be in the what? Readiness, because we must be prepared. Our motives, our intentions, our growth, our giving, our service, our relationships, and how we live in the light of the saving power of Jesus are things of the mind. Proverbs 23 verse 7 says, for as he thinks, so is he. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 3. As he thinks so, is in Proverbs chapter 4, verse what? Verse 23. We're going to read, I just copied this from somewhere. I want us to read together, or I can read for you to listen. As unbelievers, are you listening? We are naturally conformed to the world. As believers, we are no longer conformed to this world because we no longer belong to the spirit of this age. We have been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God's beloved Son. Therefore, rather than continuing to conform to this world, we are to be transformed by having our minds renewed. Our thinking must be changed, that is transformed from old, ungodly ways of thinking into new, godly ways of thinking. What we know in our minds to be true forms our conviction in our hearts of what truth, and that conviction in our heart translates into action. Therefore, we must first renew our minds. The only way to replace the error of the world's way of thinking is to replace it with God's truth. And the only infallible source of God's truth is His revealed word, the Bible. Transformation through renewed minds comes as believers expose themselves to God's word through the faithful exposition of it each week in church, in personal Bible study and group Bible study. A solid church that believes in preaching the word, reading the word, and singing the word is valuable in helping us renew our minds. There are no shortcuts. There is no magical formula for renew your mind. We must fill our mind with God's word. As Jesus prayed to the Father, sanctify them in thy truth, for your word is truth. John 17, verse what? Verse 17. Hallelujah. It's copied and quoted. Amen. There's no formula for renewal of mind. And there's no way you can do exploits, honor God, without a renewed what? A renewed mind. If we don't renew our minds will be fallow, will be shallow, our conduct will be detested. Praise the Lord. That will not be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And what God is looking for is manifestation of what? Of the sons of God. Amen. Who have solid standing, who have the word of God in them, and the character and nature of Jesus. Manifestation of those that, when we are looking at them, we say, this is a believer. Amen.
Amen.
And I pray God will take us to that level in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, we have read in Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 2, says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God, that you present your bodies what? A living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. What is the will of God? Amen. That will be our part B. What is what? The will of God. The renewal of your mind is a means to an end. And the end is what? Is that our mind be renewed. I mean, that you might do what? The will of God. And of course, also that can lead to what? Another end is for us to make the kingdom of God. But meanwhile, we are on this earth and we're supposed to shine as the light. Amen? Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In this church, you're supposed to be an example. At home, example. At place of work, what? Example. That's why we need a renewed mind. Without renewal of mind, with divine substance coming into us, with divine food coming into us, with ingredients for the Holy Ghost to use, when there is a need, when there is a call, we shall fail. And we wonder, why did I compromise? Because the mind is not what? It's not renewed. I pray we shall be renewed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What is the will of God? Perfect will of God. Not just not any how will of God. Not the one you will say, God, God is telling you this is the fellowship man. You say, no, is that tall guy with Mercedes Benz? No. After you have prayerized God, God may say, okay, your will be done. That will not be a question.
Amen.
When God says your will be done, the fellow is finished. What God is saying, whatever you meet in the front door, if what? It's your pot of tea. That will not be a question.
Amen.
So you can lead your marriage a shortcut. Better marry her. Amen. Praise the Lord. And you are very sure. You cannot come and meet pastor. Amen. If I want you, let you find the fellowship, come and meet your pastor for prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Don't look at that tall guy, dandling, borrowed Mercedes-Benz guy. Praise the Lord. Maybe borrow shoes. Amen. You can rent anything in America. Praise the Lord. In fact, I can come by next week. You see me with half a hair. I'll put a wig, amen. America, amen. Praise the Lord. So don't be deceived, amen. In fact, not only in another area, but also we should be mature Christians. That's why our mind has been filled. No, but I told you, don't run, the prophets will run after you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Don't let anybody come and deceive you. Ah, there's a prophet, he tells you the money in your account. Ah. They want to cheat you after telling you the money in your account. You come and give an offering, amen. Praise the Lord. I keep telling us there's nobody. I only once asked somebody to come and raise offering for us, and the fellow said he cannot raise offering. I said, there's nobody. I said, oh God, please, when you get there, collect offering for pastor. No. Collect offering, special offering. Those who come to collect special offering, by the grace of God, thank you for the response. Not be me to send them home. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
As God leads them, praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. So if God leads you, don't come and give a pledge that you're not going to honor. Nobody forces you to come and give. If you open our book, they fill our they're all over the place. So if you are owing, I too as a pastor will do very well. If I'm owing, I will pay, amen. Praise the Lord. But if you are owing, please. If I did not need any suffering for me, we found blank envelopes. I'm not going to pass this level. Amen. Nobody forces you to come and bless the pastor. Don't come and dance and pretend, hey, God, thank Jesus Christ, and you put a black envelope. Not on his side, you know? Praise the Lord. It doesn't make sense. Amen. Let's not be true to ourselves, God, help us in Jesus' name. The will of God. So our transformation of the mind, the renewal of all those efforts we are making secretly, and you come for Bible studies, and you take notes, and you listen to videos, you watch videos, and you listen to all these things, it should translate to what? To doing what? The perfect will of God. Amen?
Amen.
And I pray that all of us, by His grace, we are doing His perfect will.
Amen.
We don't example because of our time. It is perfect will of God is what God commands us to do. And it is the application of the Bible principles in all walks of life. It's what God says we should do, but assuming those what you want to do are not written, but it's application of the principles of the scriptures. The principle is that God is holy, we must what? We must be holy. Praise the Lord. So if you're not very clear, just apply the principles of the scripture. What does the Bible say about God? What does God's desire or require from us? Example, because of our time, let's go to them. Examples of divine requirement and the will of God. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, can we read together? Give thanks in all. Let's read together now. Give thanks. What is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you? Amen?
Amen.
What is the will of God there? Give thanks. Whether you fall into potter or Stand up, shake up your body and say, in Jesus' name, I am more than what? And give thanks. Whether you have food to eat or no food to eat, God, give thanks. Because of tomorrow is bound to be okay. Whether I have a job, whether I have green paper or not, just begin to give thanks. God can make a way through thanksgiving where you least what? Expect. Number two. 1 Thessalonians 4:7, what does it say? For this, let's go. For this is the way of God. Your sanctification. And you abstain from sexual immorality. He's talking about purity, he's talking about holiness, and he's talking about moral conduct. That is the will of God. That every man, every woman in this church, abstain from what? From immorality of any type, whether you are a teenager, married or what, or not married. Amen? Whether in the secret of your room, anywhere you are doing that, God is looking at you. Amen? If you have a problem as a youth, come and see the pastor. Amen? Don't hide and die morally. We can, by God's grace, we deal with the issues. Any challenge, let us know. Luke chapter 9, verse 3. Let's go. Then he said, take this cross daily and follow me. That is the will of God. We must be disciples of Jesus. Disciples of Christ. Of course, follow the pastor, listen to the pastor, but we are to follow Jesus. Amen? Disciples of Christ. We take on, let's call it discipline. Self-sacrifice, endurance, and patience. It does what Micah chapter 6, verse 8. What is it? He has shown you, O mortal, what is good and what does the Lord require of you? To ask out justice and to love mercy and to walk humbly before him. That is our conduct. We should be just, we should be humble, and we should be lovely. I hope you show mercy. If you don't show mercy, there's a problem there, because what you don't show, you cannot get back. I pray we shall show mercy to people in Jesus' name, really members of our household. Philippians 4, 6 to 8. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 to 8. What does it say? Be careful for not. Let's go. Be careful for not. But in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let the prayer be made known to you. That is the will of God for every one of you. Amen? Prayer, so don't worry, don't fret. Just have faith in God. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6. What does it say? Trust in the Lord with all thy mind, and lean not on thy own understanding. In all thy way acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. 5 to 6. In every way. Just depend on God. Don't fret. Don't fret. Just believe God. Don't be filled with anxiety. Don't worry on issues, but pray about them. Be concerned, but pray about them. Don't be consumed by problems, but release your mind and your problem before God. And with what? With what? With thanksgiving. That is state of mind God wants us to be, because it gives you, it enhances your health. Lastly, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 22. He says what? Abstain from all appearance of evil. Now, after everything, you don't even know what to do. And this is not written in the Bible. Like internet, it's not written in the Bible. For example, internet is not what? Did you see computer in the Bible? Now, how do you deal with computer? How do you relate with the TV? Because there was no TV in the Bible. There's no radio. Now, if you begin to consume your time, and it's not for God's purpose, what do? You apply biblical what? Biblical principle. that we should manage our time because the days are evil. In conclusion, if we ignore the Bible, we have chosen not to do the will of God. So have that at the back of your mind. If we ignore the Bible, if we ignore Bible studies, if we ignore listening to good messages, if we ignore those things, it's a decision we have made not to do the will of God. Because if you don't listen, you can't be refined. And you may think you are doing the will of God because nothing is challenging you. There's nothing challenging you to do the will of God. Someone said, the way to miss God's will is really simple. Ignore the Bible. Just ignore the Bible. If you say don't steal, ignore it. If you say forgive, ignore it. That is the way to miss God's will. You will not miss it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And that's also the way to miss heaven, is to ignore the Bible. And I pray none of us will ignore the Bible.
Amen.
We can hold the Bible as the sword of the Spirit.
Amen.
Guide our morals, guide our relationship, guide our service, guide our perspective, guide our opinions, guide our giving, guide everything we are doing in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
The Word of God. Hallelujah. Our marriage, you to marry. Ignore the Bible. In the Bible, God has told us exactly what we should do when it comes to making decisions. First, we should determine if our decision goes against anything clearly spelled out in the Bible. The Bible is explicit, very clear on the will of God. And number one, we must know is this thing written in the scriptures that I want to do. Can a Christian marry an unbeliever? Is it scriptural? The Bible has spelled out all of that. I pray we will not miss the will of God for our life in Jesus' name. Because to renew our minds is exhortation to godly living. Can we say that? The call to renew our minds is an exhortation to godly living. And godly living, of course, will lead us to what? The blessings of God and heaven in the end. Ungodly living makes one to lose or miss the blessings of God. And also to miss heaven. You will not miss heaven in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not come to church and labor because of this simple way of you can't take it up and sacrifice to renew your mind. And on the last day, one just misses. That will not be a portion in Jesus' name. Matthew 7:21 says, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. To do his will, our minds have to be constantly renewed. The Bible says, not those who call me Lord, Lord, I will enter, but those who are doing the will of my Father in heaven. Are you prepared to do the will of the Father in heaven? Is there any area of your life you say, well, this area, I think I am missing the will of God. Amen. Or I'm going my own way. I didn't pray enough. Is there any way you can look at and say, okay, this area, I think self has come in, or the world has come in. Are you beginning to do what you are not doing before? Have you left what you are doing that is making you to be a robust Christian? Have you stopped tithing because you are hearing some foreign information from somewhere and say, it is no longer necessary to tithe and all of that? How do you get there? That was a gift shall what? Shall be given unto you. Have you stopped praying because of information, this false prayer? Prayer works. It works for me and it's working for some of us and it's going to work for you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I tell you, prayer works. How it works, I don't know, but what? Prayer works. I've prayed and I've seen results. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And I pray that all of us, we just stand up and lift up our hand before the Lord. Say, Lord, here am I. Here am I, your will be done in my life. I will just trust Father. Here am I, your will be done in my life.